Yo guys, Lynn here. Welcome to part two of our modern Italian restaurant let's build. In the last episode we got this first floor done, just this one wall. In this one hopefully we'll get a lot more finished. We'll probably get the second floor started. We'll definitely get the whole of the first floor finished, because this entire wall just has to be copied for the back. So we're just redoing the sides. Okay, so we'll just get started straight away so we can get as much done as possible. What you're going to need is just sandstone, smooth sandstone, chiseled sandstone, that's difficult to say, sandstone slab, sandstone stair. I can't say sandstone, sandstone. Alright, so we've got all those five out. You can just go from the left of the door, and we're going to be building this sidewall first, okay? Alright, so we're going to take our smooth sandstone and we're gonna go just diagonal from there, and we're gonna build a wall that goes all the way up by six. Okay, we will actually make it, yeah, we'll just make it six just now. It goes up one more, but that's just to fill in the space behind here. So it goes up by six, and then we're just making these windows here. So we just have to copy those. We need to make one of those, and then we have space, then another one, then a space, then another one, space, another one, and that will be how wide this wall is. So I'm just going to go over by five, so five altogether. So 1, 2, 3, 4, 5. Okay, you can bring that all the way up, and then you can miss out a space, and then you can make another one. So 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, and then again miss a space, 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, all the way up, and then a final space and another five. Okay, so it should look something like that. That's how wide our Italian restaurant is going to be. All right, so what we're going to do is not for this end one here or the end one here, but for the rest of them, we're going to fill up all of these columns that go up and down so they're three wide. Okay, and that's just because we're going to place a window in between each of them, and we want to have kind of a sandstone block on either side of it. Okay, so that's, well, that one's already three like that, so it should look something like that. You can fill these in across the top if you want, but they're not really necessary for right now. So you should have something that looks like that. And what you can do is place in upside down stairs on every one of the corners. Just, that's pretty much what we do with all the windows in this build. Like that. Okay. It just kind of makes it like a little arch shape. And then we're going to fill in behind each of these with glass. And we're going to fill in this space here with glass as well. And we're just going to make it all the way up the same height, six, and we're going to use glass block. Okay, so starting here, you can go all the way up. Well, technically, you don't need to go up six on these ones. We'll just go up by five. I'm not sure if we need to go up by six on the middle ones, but we can add that if we come to it. I don't think we do. So up by five for all the glass blocks. Okay, this part of the build should be really simple to follow. And let's see what we have. Yep, that's perfect. From there, what we need to do is place in an upside down step right in front of there, just above each of these glass blocks in between the spaces. Okay, like that. And then we're going to bring round this, but we're not going to attach it onto this corner. We're just going to make it similar, so it's just going to stick out over the edge by one right there, and then you can bring that right along to the end. Okay, and then that's this half of the side finished once we add in just a couple of details. So this space here will be filled in with smooth sandstone, okay? This is going to get filled in all the way along. But we will do that when we fill in the floors. Okay, so all you have to do for these windows here, we're going to use anvils, oak leaves, and beacons. Okay, for each of the windows, you can place an anvil in the middle. You can place oak leaves too high above the anvils. And then you can place... Oops, I just destroyed that window. You can place a beacon at the bottom of each of the spaces. Like that. Okay, and then that's that side completely finished. So we've done two sides now. We're going to do the side right here. Okay, and then I'm just going to skip ahead for the back, because all you have to do is completely copy this side to the back, okay? So we're just going to skip that part, there's no point in watching. But again, you can just watch the first video if you want to see how to do that, okay? So we're going to go on to this side now, from this block here. Okay, we're not going to go the same as we did last time, where it was diagonal, like that. Okay, and this block here is actually the first block in our wall. So again, we're going to do the same as over there with the windows, okay, but they're going to be slightly different looking. So we have the wall here, okay, this is the first block. You can go along by 1, 2, 3, 4 and back down. Alright, and then you can place your upside down stairs on the corners of there. And then you can move along by 1, 2, 3, 4 there. And go all the way down. You can see that it's different from the ones over here, because these ones are kind of separate windows. But these ones here are attached. Okay? And that's just because the side over there is actually wider than this side. Because you can see this one goes in by 3. Okay, so we've got that. Again, you can put in your upside down stair. There and there. And you can fill in this with glass block. And then we can go and add in another two windows like this. We're going to separate it by a space of 3, which we're going to fill in with a chiseled stone. So you can just make a wall that goes up all the way, sticks out by 1, made of the chiseled sandstone. Okay, and then again, you can just repeat what we did there. Using the smooth sandstone, you can make a wall that goes along a space of 3 in the middle for your window. And that's exactly the same, okay? So we'll fill this in. You can see here that this block, if you're building that side over there, this block is just the same as this block here, okay? So you're just going to build this side over there. So you're just going to make a window that goes right here. You can just kind of copy that side over there. It's completely opposite from this side. Okay, so if there's a window over there, then you have a window here. Okay, so that means it's really simple to copy. So the window's the same, the door will be completely opposite each other. Everything should be really simple to follow. Okay, I'm just going to fill in these glass blocks. And then I'm going to copy that side to here. And I will show you what it looks like when we're finished. Alright guys, so that's the back completely finished. There's only one thing left to do that I didn't explain to you. And that's, where does the upside down stairs go on this side? And all you have to do is bring up this 3 chiseled sandstone blocks up by 1. And it's just going to be the same as we did around here. And you're going to attach it onto the chisel stone block. Okay, so you can just bring that along there. And then do the same on this side. Okay? So that's all we have to do on there. And then finally on this side as well. You can dig out a block there, miss a space, block, miss a space, block. Okay, like that. And then you can take beacons, anvil, and I'm going to use still oak leaves. You can fill in each of these with a beacon. Okay, and then the space here, you can fill it in with an anvil and oak leaves. And the same on this side. Okay, guys, and that's the bottom floor of our Italian restaurant completely finished. Okay? So in the next episode, we'll get started on the next floor. What I'm going to do, though, before I start that, is I'm going to fill in the entire floor. Okay? So what we can do first, just before we finish, is we can kind of square off the next floor. So, starting from the front, okay, you can go to the corner here and fill in a block. Okay, it can just be any of the sandstone blocks. I'm just going to use regular sandstone. Okay, and then I'm going to build a line going right down, okay, all the way to the bottom here and attach it on there. And then I'm going to do the same on this side, okay, starting from the same as we did over here. So it'll be the right hand side. Well, actually it'll be the left hand side since it's opposite. Draw a line going all the way down, okay, right down to the bottom to there. Okay, and I'm going to fill in all of this side here, all these open spaces, okay? So all of this can just be filled in with sandstone. And that's because the second floor, the floor isn't going to be sandstone, but the outside needs to look like it's sandstone. So we're just going to fill in kind of like all these edges with sandstone. When you get to this corner here, you can just leave it like a corner like that, okay? And we can fill in this side as well, exactly the same. Okay, so those two sides are filled in. And then all you're going to do for the two remaining sides is just add on one more layer of sandstone, okay? So the sandstone should be too thick on that side and too thick on this side. And that's just so we can place wall on top of it. Okay, the remaining of this giant square is going to get filled in with something. And I'm going to use chiseled quartz block, okay? And you can decide what texture you want for your floor, but I'm going to use that for this texture pack. Okay, that's what it looks like. Okay, guys, so for the next video, I'll have that filled in, just this giant square, and then we can get started on the next floor. Okay, guys, so if you enjoyed the build tutorial, don't forget to leave a like and comment, and also subscribe to keep up to date with all my videos. And guys, I will see you next time.